Hello. In this video, I'll be looking at using low code development for production environments. Specifically, I'll be looking at the open source Node-RED project, which released its 1.0 version towards the end of 2019. When I talk to developers at events I go to, one of the common comments I hear about low code development is that it isn't for real developers. Developers write code. Low code is for a non-developer. However, I don't agree with that. When I look at the evolution of the developer role from the early days of computing to the role today, there are several trends I can follow. Low-level complexity has been abstracted away from the developer, freeing the developer to focus on the application functionality. Libraries, packages, SDKs, and frameworks have been introduced so the developer can quickly add functionality without having to code from scratch. Again, often hiding low-level complexity and delivering a higher level of abstraction for the developer to work against. New computer languages and tools add features to aid the developer in creating robust code more quickly. I see low-code development as a logical continuation of these trends, providing higher levels of abstraction and allowing rapid application development with minimal learning. This allows a developer to be more productive and can drastically reduce the development time for a project. Low-code development isn't going to be appropriate for every solution, but it should be part of a developer's toolkit. For each application, a developer needs to look at the functional and non-functional requirements and use the appropriate technology to create the application that meet those requirements. I also hear a number of comments from developers that low-code development is only suitable for a prototype or a proof of concept, as having the development tools and runtime combined isn't appropriate for production. Also, low-code environments don't fit within the development processes and tooling. To use Node-RED in a production environment, it does need to be integrated into the tooling and processes used by the development team. Most developers today using Node-RED tend to use a single environment for both development and runtime, which is clearly not suitable for production use. When adopting Node-RED for production, there are some things that need to be taken into consideration. Testing. This requires a different approach as many of the existing testing methodologies are built around traditional coding, where code can be stubbed or tested in isolation. Node-RED is an open source technology with a large community of developers contributing nodes. So that, like all open source technology, you need to have a good approach to evaluating suitable packages for use, especially for production use. You need to ensure the developers of the package have created something of production quality, with comprehensive testing in place, and that error conditions are handled in an appropriate manner. But this is no different from many other programming languages where libraries and packages are open source and managed by a community of developers. Node-RED is low code, not no code. So if there isn't a suitable node that provides the required functionality, then you're going to have to write code. And there are a number of ways to integrate code within Node-RED. There is the function node, where you can write JavaScript and access any existing Node.js package. You can drop into the underlying Node Express application, which hosts the Node-RED runtime, and add code there. Or if appropriate, you can create new nodes to add the needed functionality into Node-RED. You need to adopt an approach for developing with low-code technology that fits into your DevOps delivery pipeline. There needs to be full version control over the application, and there needs to be a build and delivery pipeline so low-code developed applications are handled like all other applications created with more traditional technology. Following on from this video, there are three tutorials which will take you through integrating Node-RED into a delivery pipeline, where you're going to learn how to use source control with Node-RED, how to package a Node-RED application into a container, and how to manage configuration data in Node-RED applications to avoid the configuration being baked into the containers.